Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you how to use DAX Studio to find the slowest measure in a DAX query. Why this technique can be useful? Imagine we have a report in Power BI where we have a visualization that has multiple measures and this visualization is slow. We can see that using Performance Analyzer and I can do this execution looking at the timing. Now, when I look at the time I spent here, I see that this single visual has a query spending more than 1 second. So this is a slow DAX query. But probably out of these four measures, only one is a very slow one. Which one is the slowest measure? I can do this in Power BI. I can remove all the measures, add one measure at a time, try to measure the performance, and this way you can find the slowest measure. But this process required to change the layout, to spend time moving things around, and DAX Studio can provide you the same information in a more efficient way. Let's see how. First of all, I have to copy the query and copy the query from the Performance Analyzer in DAX Studio. So once again, I open the Performance Analyzer, I refresh the visual and I copy the query here, and I paste this query in DAX Studio. Now in DAX Studio I can execute the same query here and with the server timings I can check what is the timing of the execution in a more detailed way. This only confirms at this point that this query is slow because I see the same information that I have seen in Performance Analyzer. The total execution time is more than 1 second. But now in order to find the slowest query I can do a more efficient operation, which is I just comment out all the measures but one, and so I will run the same query with just one measure. Let's do this with the quantity. So I can comment these three lines. There is a button comment in DAX Studio that helps me doing that. And then, making sure I have a valid syntax, I run the execution. Now, quantity, which is the first measure, is not a slow measure. It runs in only 7 milliseconds. So certainly this is not the problem. And I can continue this process by commenting this time quantity and I uncomment sales amount. Now when I run this query, I press F5 to make it quicker, I see that this query runs in 13 milliseconds, which is still fast. So now I try with the total cost, which is the third measure, and this query is still, oops, I made a mistake. Look at this. I have this comma and this is makes this syntax a non-valid syntax, so I have to remember to make sure that the syntax I obtain is valid. You should not have a comma at the end of the syntax before the closed parentheses. But once again, also this is a fast query. So guess what? The last measure under 1000 sales is probably the slowest measure of this query. Now I know, and in a moment you will see this, now I know that, oh, this measure is the responsible for the slowest query in the report, and so I have to focus my effort of optimization only in one measure to optimize the entire report, which is a topic for another video. Enjoy DAX!